So we're getting right into it. Wait, didn't save. It says bar champ. Oh, okay. All right. So this is I don't know. Losers round two.
Oh, reverse bear. Oh, he's still going. Okay. Okay, he's got us, but he can shoot.
I don't know. I don't know how like experienced DT is with this matchup, honestly. Because like you don't play Kirby really anymore, and
yeah, I think he needs to harness the power of his love Kirby. Make Kirby a glass cannon because Pikachu has the power to shoot. No, Pikachu has lots of percent. All he needs to watch out really.
Smashes, grabs, nares.
You can't do that on the shield.
Yeah.
You can't do up air on the shield like that. You air into grab or forward air.
Well,
with CVG, oh, okay.
See, forward air on shield is not safe because CVG can just pop out that nair before he gets to him. The up airs are good, but he got too close.
And that was a great read with the fair on GT's up B. He was trying to catch him after the up B, and the fair would have lasted. He would be able to get a combo after it. That was a really good fair.
The CVG respecting Pika at the ledge.
And
the up air can poke through the stage.
If you notice, he's respecting Pika in neutral, never over committing, and that's when he's making people approach him.
What can make. Ooh,
good
read on that jump. What can make Kirby very dangerous in this matchup is, again, that patience. Because you have to let Pika make the mistake. Let Pika back air into and then throw out the up tilt to catch him with it. Kirby without plat movement though has a very hard time getting in on Pika. So,
for sure.
Really, Kirby's best tool in this matchup is probably his back air. I'd say. That's
per
like,
se.
Yeah, per se. I would per se back air is.
Oh no.
From the Pika perspective, the move I'm looking out for the most is back air. Up tilt is a crazy good combo starter for Kirby, but like there are ways to avoid it.
Man, he barely got out of there by skin of his pants. Buttocks.
Like, Kirby, you know when he's gonna up tilt because he's sitting on the ground, right? He's never gonna surprise you with an up tilt, but. There can be a very surprising,
that's the beautiful thing about Kirby, which is that you're conditioned to never, to always expect it. And a lot of stuff's in crazy metagames with mentalities that you have to account for.
Right, I'm just saying, like, Kirby has to be on the ground to up tilt, so it's very hard to, like, catch someone off guard with it.
Air and the move against Pikachu, back air in the air, so you know if you're above Kirby, or you're spacing up air correctly, you beat him every single exchange.
Cool. That's really the most you can do to like surprise someone with the up tilts, pivot into him. GT's got to be ready for that. Especially now that he's seen Stevie pull it out at least once. I think he wanted a fastball there on the back air.
I'm not gonna lie, I realize when I commentate, I talk over other people all the time.
Oh, don't worry. Yeah,
so
don't worry
I'm
about
the worst
it.
With that. So I'm trying to work with the commentator flow.
That's why. That's actually.
In the girth,
that's why I'm talking over you. So like, to kind
of
show
Mark
like.
Mark is the meta of the commentator.
I'm not. Yeah, I'm not. I'm not a good commentator.
Honestly. I hate to say it, but.
Yeah, GT still plays a pretty grounded game. That works. That's like how you want to play against Falcon, but against Kirby, you're right. Kirby, Yoshi, you want to kind of take to the air a little bit. Try and sneak in those back airs.
And if you just face up air correctly, it practically beats everything.
That's
what I'm saying. Like he has to go up to the platform and then jump down to be above Kirby.
Oh, that was a great follow up on that. That was a good edge guard.
Boxed him out and then was able to get the up air.
Yeah.
But you could have had that play earlier and kill up on the platform.
And CVG takes that first game. Yeah, the, like up air is a very destructive ability, but the problem is that it has a very short duration. Like, it doesn't last very long, and it doesn't have a lot of knockback. So a lot of times you can hit someone like Kirby with an up air and get a retaliation.
And not get a follow up.
Yeah.
But the main problem is that it
doesn't stay out very long. It's hard to like consistently.
And what stays out long is neutral air.
There you go.
So that's why I have to be above Kirby.
DT's still working on his combo. So he had the right idea. He went for the nair, but he just didn't get the a high enough jump. Yeah, all the Kirby's are going to be waiting for that up tilt at the ledge. So they'll mix up the down air. Hard to stay.
DT had a little bit better DI. He could have gotten attack.
Yeah, I mean, that's tough.
But he plays video. Like, he got most of it. Like, almost as DI didn't get it. I thought he was on the platform now, is this?
Right. Oh, CDG was dashing in and out, and GT really just waited for that up tilt.
There we go, finally he makes Kirby the glass cannon, because he is against Pikachu, he's a glass cannon.
Oh, the ledge hop forward air, that shouldn't work.
See, and I don't know if GT knows, but if they don't DI properly in the fair when you get it, you can get a free up smash after. Because instead of jab grab after the fair, you got an up smash, which lets you beat Newt up air back air, which is probably what it could be. Yeah, I keep hearing this by mic.
No, I think she's saying, Pika Kirby.
Hey, that's why I said we have
to this matchup's like really like mentally engaging if you know what's going on. It gets a lot more fun to watch when CVG's got some good things as Kirby, but like when you get like the really good plat movement, you can watch like players like Revan. Is that Ocelot? I think, like, somebody changed their tag. I think Ocelot changed his tag to Catwolf. I forget, one of those guys. It's a Florida guy.
But, Harry, Command, I think, has done some adjustment, and that, bada bing, bada boom. So, like I said, Jesus. I think he's staying to the ground still. I think what you said is right. I think he needs to game, and like I said, I think he needs to come forward if we get
some. Wait, no, Kirby above Pikachu.
I mean, no, I'm saying if Pikachu is above Kirby, he comes
forward. Oh, yeah. The thing, like, all you can do with Kirby in that situation is either get to the ground for an up tilt or back air. Back air has a weird hitbox above Kirby.
No, it covers his whole body.
Yeah.
But what's even crazier is Kirby's up air at 0% has set knockback. So
yeah.
At 0%, Kirby's up air is actually good sometimes.
Yeah.
People say, you know, Kirby's up air is trash and the hitbox really is. It's not useful in any situation except for it.
Usually shield break. You get a shield break on the side plat, I think you can up air to like down air, up air ledge cancel down air, and let's say a really good DI. I think Kiro used to do that back when he played 64. Oh, I think the F smash might have actually reached. It has a really big hitbox.
I think he had to wait a second then F smash.
So
what I tell you, he's on the platform going out for Kirby and he's getting the edge roll. All you need to take that neutral.
If bring this back, it's a tough one.
Got really respect this space.
Oh yeah. He just got inside him with that back air and Not enough hits done. So, DVG, 2-0. DVG.